Hi guys, Britt and Oz here. Thank you very, very much for joining me again. So this is going to be another rugby video. And today we will be previewing week four of the autumn international games that are coming up this weekend. We have Italy versus Tonga, England versus Argentina, Scotland are playing Georgia, Ireland playing Australia, Wales are heading off against South Africa, and France are playing New Zealand. Let's start with the Italy-Tonga game. Now, Italy played well against South Africa, deserved their win. South Africa have been poor, but take nothing away from Italy, played very, very well. Tonga, been in the international doldrums for a little while now, has just disappeared off the radar. Not to say I haven't got the players, but lack of money, the players haven't been given the exposure that maybe some of the other Pacific Islands have had. Unfortunate, Italy to win this probably by 30 points, I think. Yeah, I'm pretty confident of an Italy victory on this one. Moving on to Twickenham, England are playing Argentina. Obviously, England are on a bit of a roll at the moment, playing very, very well. They're very confident. They've got a good setup, good bunch of players. They tested out some of their other combinations last week against Fiji, and it turns out it worked pretty well. Played some excellent rugby. Argentina started off their tour slowly, lost last week, lost 2 weeks in a row actually, lost to Wales, and then they lost to Scotland. They'll be very disappointed. They'll be pumped up for this game. England-Argentina games are always big affairs, always physical encounters, but I think England are going to win this 10 to 15 points. I think it'll be physical, it'll be brutal, but England will come out on top. Moving on, we have Scotland playing Georgia, in fact, this week. Georgia actually beat Samoa last week, 2016, so there are no pushovers. Georgia have almost caused some upsets in the past. They've almost beaten Ireland before in the World Cup. They've pushed England. They're a good side. They've got some very, very good individual players who play in France. I don't think they'll have enough to beat Scotland. Scotland will be full of confidence after beating Argentina and running Australia so close. It'd be an interesting game, but Scotland have too much. I'll back Scotland by 20 this week. I just don't think Georgia will have it in them to beat Scotland. This is a very interesting game coming up. We've got Ireland playing Australia. Ireland have come off the back of a loss. They copped some cheap shots against New Zealand, but not to say that New Zealand shouldn't have won that game, because they should have, and they did, and they won it well. Australia played well in patches against France, came away with a win. It's going to be interesting. I think Ireland will win this one. I think Ireland will squeak by 5 to 7 points. I don't think it'll be a classic encounter. I think it'll be close. But Ireland will, I believe Ireland will win. Australia at the moment are up and down. They're pretty unpredictable. And Ireland have been sailing a fairly steady course. So yeah, Ireland to win this one. Next up, Wales against South Africa. This one is interesting. It's going to be difficult for South Africa to pull anything out of this. They're in such a low at the moment. They're such a low. I said a few weeks ago, if Wales were going to win any game against the Southern Hemisphere, the Australian game was the one for them to target. However, the way that South Africa have been playing and their severe lack of confidence, this is actually the game that they are going to target to win. They're going to go all out to win. I think they're going to need a bit more creativity. At the moment, they're playing quite laterally. That has been a bit of a problem in Wales lately. But if they get a bit of go for ball and a bit of creativity, then of course South Africa some problems. South Africa have got class. They have got class. They're a good side and they've got speed out wide. I just feel as though they're in such a low at the moment. Wales are going to finally get that victory that they've craved against Southern Hemisphere teams. I think Wales will win probably around about 10 points. Although it won't be a blowout. I think, yeah, it'll be fairly close. But Wales are going to, I think Wales will come away with it. Okay, last game of the weekend that we're going to cover. And it's the France-New Zealand game. This one, New Zealand's, even if a couple of guys get suspended retroactively for a couple of challenges made against Ireland, I still think they're going to have a bit too much. These guys have got such strength and depth. Bowden Barrett, again, the guy is just, he's a fair freak. at the moment. He's playing so well. New Zealand as a unit has always played well. France played okay, actually, last weekend. Australia came away with a narrow loss. I feel like New Zealand are going to have too much for this France team. I think New Zealand win 10 to 15 points. Again, I don't think New Zealand will run away with it. I think France will peg them fairly close. And actually, France have been a bit of a tricky side for New Zealand in the past, but I think New Zealand are going to have this game in the bag. All right, guys, I would love to see what your score predictions in the comments. Let me know who you think is going to win, what score is going to be. If you like the video, give it a like. Please subscribe if you want to see more, and I will see you next time. Thanks, guys.